Hello students, today we are going to discuss about the refrigerants, its definition, classification and desirable properties. Okay. Now the first thing, there is definition of the refrigerant. Okay, refrigerant. Now, as we know, the refrigerant is the working fluid which absorbs heat from one body and reject it to another body. Refrigerant is a working fluid which absorbs heat from one body and reject it to the another body. Okay, generally it is through the evaporation and condensation. म्हणजे बघा, रेफ्रिजरंट हे एक वर्किंग फ्लुइड आहे जे हीट ऍब्सॉर्ब करतं एका बॉडीकडून आणि रिजेक्ट करतं दुसऱ्या बॉडीला. आता याच्यामध्ये आपण वेपर कॉम्प्रेशन रेफ्रिजरेशन सिस्टीम बघितली किंवा आपलं डोमेस्टिक रेफ्रिजरेटर बघितलेलं आहे, तर डोमेस्टिक रेफ्रिजरेटरमध्ये बघा, रेफ्रिजरंट म्हणजे त्याच्यामध्ये असणारा मीडिया असेल, वर्किंग फ्लुइड असेल, जो R134a आपण वापरतो. R134a हा रेफ्रिजरंट आपण कशामध्ये वापरतो? डोमेस्टिक रेफ्रिजरेटर मध्ये वापरतो. तर हा रेफ्रिजरंट म्हणजे काय असेल? दॅट विल ऍब्सॉर्ब हीट फ्रॉम द कंटेंट ऑफ द रेफ्रिजरेटर अँड डिलिव्हर इट टू द ऍटमॉस्फिअर. नाव ड्युरिंग दॅट प्रोसेस it will get evaporated during absorption of heat and it will get condensed during rejection of heat. Okay, we can use different fluids, okay, for absorption and rejection of the heat. We can use air as a media or working fluid. Air, that is one of the refrigerant. Water, that is again one of the refrigerant. Carbon dioxide, ammonia, okay, sulfur dioxide. These are the some of the names of the refrigerants. Okay, now again I am repeating definition of refrigerant. It is the working fluids which absorbs heat from one body and reject it to the another body. That is the refrigerant. Now next thing, that is classification of the refrigerant. Now how the refrigerants are classified? The refrigerants are classified in two groups, that is primary refrigerant and secondary refrigerant. Primary refrigerant and secondary refrigerant. Okay. Now, what primary refrigerant includes, or how the primary refrigerants are classified? Primary refrigerants are classified as, first one, that is halocarbon refrigerants. Primary refrigerants. In that, halocarbon refrigerants next, that is azeotropes refrigerant. Next, there is inorganic refrigerants. And next, there is fans. Hydrocarbon refrigerants. Now we are going to discuss one by one. These are from primary refrigerants, and one more, that is secondary refrigerant. Primary refrigerant and B, that is secondary refrigerant. Okay. Now, how that is classified? Two groups, that is primary refrigerant and secondary refrigerant. What do you mean by primary refrigerant? Okay. Now, primary refrigerants are the refrigerants which are directly take part in absorbing and rejection of the heat. That refrigerant directly absorb heat from the system and reject it to the atmosphere. Okay. These are the primary refrigerant. Okay. We have seen the domestic refrigerator, water cooler. Okay. In these systems, or air conditioner. Okay. In this system, different refrigerants absorb heat. Okay. Directly. Okay. Now R134A, that refrigerant absorb heat in the domestic refrigerator. Okay. It will absorb that in circuit. That refrigerant will flow from compressor, compressor to condenser, condenser to expansion device. After expansion device, it will transfer to the, it will flow to the evaporator. In evaporator, that refrigerant will absorb heat, okay? And again, it will pass to the compressor. After that compressor, it is passed to the condenser, okay? Now, that refrigerant, compressor, condenser, expansion device, evaporator, and again compressor. These are the four major components. Compressor, condenser, expansion device, and evaporator. Now over here, when the refrigerant is compressed, it will transfer to the condenser. In condenser, that refrigerant will reject heat to the atmosphere. Okay. Now, after that, the refrigerant is passed to the expansion device and it is again passed to the evaporator, where it will absorb heat. या ठिकाणी heat काय करणार आहे, absorb करणार आहे, आणि या ठिकाणी काय करणार आहे, reject करणार आहे. आणि तो refrigerant जो आहे तो system मधून काय होतो, flow होतो, circuit मधून काय होतो, flow photo. Now over here, that refrigerant will absorb heat directly. तो स्वतः या ठिकाणी काय करतो, absorb करतो. आणि इथे सुद्धा तो काय करतो, atmosphere ला reject करतो. Okay, that is the primary refrigerant. That is the primary refrigerant. आणि secondary मध्ये कसं असतं? That secondary refrigerant. Okay. That will reject heat to the primary refrigerant and secondary refrigerant. These two refrigerants, we have seen in case of ice plant as well as chilling center. Okay, over there, ice plant. Okay, and chilling center. Okay. In both, we have seen ammonia, that is used as a primary refrigerant, and water. Over here in ice plant, there is drying solution. Okay, and over here, water. Primary refrigerant. Two different circuits are there. In first circuit, that is primary refrigerant, that was ammonia. Okay, and in secondary circuit, in case of ice plant, there is a brine solution, and in case of chilling center, there was water. Okay, now primary refrigerant will absorb heat from secondary refrigerant, and secondary refrigerant will absorb heat from the system which is to be cooled. Means two different refrigerants are used over here in these two plants. Okay, these are the secondary refrigerants, these are the primary refrigerants. Okay, this is about primary refrigerant and secondary refrigerant. Now we will discuss one by one, that is primary refrigerants. Now from primary refrigerant, first one, there is halocarbon refrigerants. Halocarbon refrigerants. Halocarbon refrigerants. Now halocarbon, okay, in that first one, the word itself explains it, that is halocarbon. Halo means it will contain the halogen atoms. Okay, halogen atoms means what? That is chlorine, fluorine. Okay, that these are the halogen elements. Okay, now if it contains halogen element, it is called as halocarbon compounds or halocarbon refrigerants. Okay, now these are the refrigerants comes under freon family. Freon family. Okay, now which are those refrigerants? These refrigerants are R11, R12, okay, then R13, 14, okay, these are some names or these are the nomenclatures of the refrigerant. We will discuss in next lecture how it designated, refrigerants are designated. Now these are the nomenclatures of the refrigerants. Okay, its names are, or chemical formulas are like this: CCl3F, CCl2F2, CClF3, CFO. Okay. Now these are generally methane based refrigerants. Okay, that is methane based. Methane, what is the chemical formula that of methane? That is CH4. Okay, methane based means over here that is hydrogen atom from the methane that is replaced by halogen atoms, that is chlorine and fluorine. Chlorine and fluorine, these are the halogens. Okay, why it is called as halogen? Because it needs one electron for the stabilization. Okay, in its outermost orbit. Okay, how? Let us take example H. These are the elements. Okay. Okay. Hydrogen, helium, lithium, beryllium, boron, carbon, neon, nitrogen, oxygen, fluorine, neon, sodium, magnesium, aluminium, silicon, phosphorus, sulfur, chlorine, argon, potassium, calcium. Okay, now hydrogen, first element, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19. Okay, now over here we can see fluorine, that is 9 number. Fluorine, that is 17 number, and hydrogen, that is first number. Okay, CH4, how the structure of CH4 is there. Okay, one carbon atom, carbon, that is 6. Okay, carbon, that is 6. How it will get distributed in the orbits? That is 2 plus 4. In first orbit, there will be 2 electrons, and in second orbit, there will be 4 electrons. 1, 2, 3, and 4. Okay. Now, to stable this carbon atom, there is a need of 4 electrons, more 4 electrons in second orbit. This will be first orbit, this will be second orbit. In second orbit, there is need of first orbit, second orbit. In second orbit, there is need of 8 electrons. Now, to make it stable, or to get stable, okay, how it gets stable? By sharing electron with the hydrogen. Okay, this will be hydrogen atom. One more hydrogen, electron of hydrogen. हा जो आहे तो कार्बनचा इलेक्ट्रॉन असेल आणि हा जो आहे तो इलेक्ट्रॉन हायड्रोजनचा असेल. हायड्रोजनच्या पहिल्या ऑर्बिट मध्ये बघा 2 इलेक्ट्रॉन झालेले आहेत. ओके, आणि कार्बनच्या पहिल्या ऑर्बिट मध्ये 2 आहेत, दुसऱ्या ऑर्बिट मध्ये किती झाले आता 5 झालेले आहेत. वन मोर हायड्रोजन आयटम, दॅट इज one more hydrogen atom over here. Okay, again one more hydrogen. 4 hydrogen atoms. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, and one carbon atom. That's why it is become CH4. It is become CH4. Now, this hydrogen atoms are replaced with the halogens. Which are the halogens? That is chlorine, chlorine and fluorine. Okay. Now, for fluorine, total 9 atoms are there, elements, 9 electrons are there. Okay. 2 plus 7 means one more required over here. Chlorine, that is 17. How 17 electrons will get distributed? 2 plus 8 plus 7. Means in its outermost orbit, there are 7 electrons. Okay, and to get stable, it needs one more electron. Okay, now let us take an example of CClF3. Okay, CClF3. One carbon atom will be there. Okay, in carbon first orbit, there will be 2 electrons. In second orbit of the carbon, there will be 4 electrons. 1, 2, 3, and 4 electrons. Okay, now CClF3. Okay, how the chlorine will be there? 3 orbits will be there for the chlorine. First orbit, over here chlorine. In first orbit, there will be 2 electrons. In second orbit, there will be 8 electrons. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 electrons will be there in second orbit. Okay. And in third orbit, 7 electrons of the chlorine and 1 electron of the carbon. Total electrons will be 8 electrons. 7 H asti ani 8va jo asel to yacha asel. Ha jo ahe to one more electron ya tikani kay karnar ahe, share karnar ahe. Okay, how it will become share? Now fluorine atom, ya tikani baga fluorine, ya pahilya orbit madhe 2 electrons,
दुसरे ऑर्बिट मध्ये किती आहेत, 7 आहेत, याचे 7 प्लस 1 याचा असेल आणि याला आणखीन एक ते काय करेल, शेअर करेल. वन मोर फ्लोरीन इट विल शेयर. फ्लोरीन फर्स्ट ऑर्बिट 2 इलेक्ट्रॉन्स, सेकेंड ऑर्बिट 8 इलेक्ट्रॉन्स, वन मोर फ्लोरीन इट विल शेयर. फर्स्ट ऑर्बिट 2 इलेक्ट्रॉन्स, सेकेंड ऑर्बिट 8 इलेक्ट्रॉन्स. ओके, this is become C carbon Cl, one chlorine atom, and F3 three fluorine atoms. Okay, its name will be monochloro, mono means single, monochloro trifluoro methane, because this is the methane based synthetic or artificially made halocarbon refrigerants. This will be dichloro, दोन आहेत क्लोरीन, डायफ्लोरो मिथेन, ट्राइक्लोरो मोनोफ्लोरो मीथेन, ट्राइक्लोरो तीन क्लोरीन आहे, मोनोफ्लोरो सिंगल क्लोरीन आहे, मीथेन. ओके, दिस इज टेट्राफ्लोरो मीथेन. टेट्राफ्लोरो Okay, this is about the halocarbon refrigerants which contain halogen atoms. Now these refrigerants having good thermodynamic properties, these were widely used, but it contains the halogen atoms, fluorine, chlorine, and these atoms are very harmful to ozone layer, that will cause for the depletion of the ozone, because hydrogen, chlorine, fluorine, these are react with the ozone and that will deplete the ozone layer. That's why in future these type of refrigerants will the use of that is going to be reduced. Okay, this is about halocarbon refrigerants. Now next, that is azeotrope refrigerants. Now that azeotropes means it is the mixture. Okay, now azeotropes are the mixture of two different refrigerants. Okay, आर्टिफिशियली केलेलं असेल, दोन वेगवेगळे रेफ्रिजरंट्स काय केले जातील, एकत्र केले जातील, बट द प्रॉपर्टीज विल बी आयडेंटिकल. प्रॉपर्टीज ज्या आहेत, हा जो थर्ड ए रेफ्रिजरंट आणि बी रेफ्रिजरंट समजा कंबाईन केला आणि त्याचा सी रेफ्रिजरंट जर फॉर्म केला, तर याच्या ज्या प्रॉपर्टीज आहेत दॅट विल बी आयडेंटिकल फॉर वाईड रेंज ऑफ टेम्परेचर्स. ओके, या काय राहतील, याच्या प्रॉपर्टीज आयडेंटिकल राहतील फॉर दी वाईड रेंज ऑफ टेम्परेचर्स. दीज आर दी एझिओट्रोप रेफ्रिजरंट्स आर दी मिक्सचर्स ऑफ दी टू डिफरंट ऑर मोर रेफ्रिजरंट्स. ओके, नाउ टेक सम एक्झाम्पल्स ऑफ एझिओट्रोप रेफ्रिजरंट्स, दॅट इज R500, R502, R503, R504. These are the examples of azeotroph refrigerants. Now R500, its chemical formula will be, or it is a combination of CCl2F2, monochloro difluoro methane. Okay, हा जो आहे तो आपण पहिल्यांदा बघितलेला जे आहे हॅलोकार्बन रेफ्रिजरेंट आहे आणि CH3CHF2. ओके, दिस इज द मिक्सचर ऑफ दीज टू रेफ्रिजरेंट R500. नेक्स्ट रेफ्रिजरेंट दैट इज R502, दैट इज CHClF2. CHClF2 and CClF2CF3. CF3. This refrigerant is formed by combination of these two refrigerants and its properties will be identical for wide range of temperature. म्हणजे हे दोन मिक्स केल्यानंतर याच्या प्रॉपर्टीज ज्या आहेत, इंडिव्हिज्युअल प्रॉपर्टीज ज्या आहेत, त्या काय होणार आहेत, चेंज होणार आहेत. आणि तिसरा जो मिक्सर झाल्यानंतरचा जो रेफ्रिजरेंट असणार आहे, त्याच्या ज्या प्रॉपर्टीज असतील त्या वाईड रेंज ऑफ टेम्परेचर साठी काय असतील, आयडेंटिकल असतील. ओके, दिस इज द अबाउट एजिओट्रोफ रेफ्रिजरेंट. नेक्स्ट दैट इज इनऑर्गेनिक रेफ्रिजरेंट. इनऑर्गेनिक रेफ्रिजरेंट, इनऑर्गेनिक रेफ्रिजरेंट. ओके, इनऑर्गेनिक रेफ्रिजरेंट्स वेर वाइडली यूज्ड बिफोर द हेलोकार्बन रेफ्रिजरेंट्स वेर नॉट देयर. हॅलोकार्बन रेफ्रिजरंट जे आर्टिफिशियल रेफ्रिजरंट्स आहेत ते ज्यावेळी नव्हते त्याच्या म्हणजे किंवा याच्या अगोदर इनऑर्गॅनिक रेफ्रिजरंट जे आहेत ते काय केले जायचे, यूज केले जायचे. नाउ दीज रेफ्रिजरंट्स आर जनरली नॅचरली ऑकर्स. ओके, दीज रेफ्रिजरंट्स आर द अमोनिया, दॅट इज R717, then carbon dioxide, sulfur dioxide, okay, then air, natural air, okay, that sulfur dioxide that is R764, okay, carbon dioxide that is R744 and air that is R729. ओके, हे सेवन जे आहे ना, हे सेवन दॅट इज द म्हणजे याचं नॉमेनक्लेचर करत असताना सेवन काय या ठिकाणी आहे, तर या सेवन वरून दिसतं की ते इनऑर्गॅनिक रेफ्रिजरंट्स आहे. ओके, इनऑर्गॅनिक रेफ्रिजरंट्स असतील तर या ठिकाणी सेवन फिगर काय केली जाते, नॉमेनक्लेचर मध्ये यूज केली जाते. ओके, दीज आर दी नॅचरली, ओके, स्टेबल फॉर्म मध्ये हे रेफ्रिजरंट्स काय होतात, मिळतात. ओके, दीज आर दी इनऑर्गॅनिक रेफ्रिजरंट्स. ओके, नेक्स्ट दॅट इज हायड्रोकार्बन रेफ्रिजरंट्स. हायड्रोकार्बन रेफ्रिजरंट्स, next that is hydrocarbon refrigerants. Hydrocarbon refrigerants, okay, this is fourth one, hydrocarbon refrigerants. Now hydrocarbon means what? It will contain hydrogen and carbon. Okay, like methane, ethane, okay, which contains the hydrogen and carbon. These are the methylene, ethylene, okay, in this group, that hydrocarbon refrigerants are occur. That is the hydrocarbon refrigerant. Now next, that is secondary refrigerants. Now, sometimes it is not desirable to carry the heat directly from the place or the place which is to be cooled. Okay, and over there the secondary refrigerants are used. Okay, so that secondary refrigerant will absorb heat. Okay, from the place which is to be cooled, and that refrigerant is cooled by primary refrigerants. Now, which are the secondary refrigerants? Generally used secondary refrigerants are water, okay, then brine solution, okay, or third air, okay. These are generally used secondary refrigerants. Now, secondary refrigerant, we can see if these refrigerants are leak, okay, into the system, these are not too much harmful. Okay, now where these refrigerants were used, we have seen already. Okay, the applications of secondary refrigerant. Water were used in the chilling center. Okay, chilling center jya hai, that is kali kaya kela hota, water use kela hota. We visited chilling center Pidri. Okay, over there water were used to cool the milk. Okay, means compressor, upper compressor, condenser will be there, upper condenser, expansion wall will be there, upper expansion wall, evaporator coils. Okay, and then it is transferred to the again compressor. And secondary refrigerant is okay, evaporator. This will be primary circuit and this will be secondary circuit. Okay, in primary circuit they can use ammonia as a refrigerant. Okay, and in secondary circuit that may be used water or brine solution. ओके हा काय असेल टँक असेल या टँक मध्ये वॉटर किंवा ब्राइन सोल्यूशन असेल. ओके हे प्रायमरी सर्किट आहे. प्रायमरी सर्किट मध्ये अमोनिया कॉम्प्रेस होईल, कंडेन्सरला जाईल, या ठिकाणी कंडेन्सर एक्सपान्शन डिवाइस, आणि इथं काय असेल इव्हॅपोरेटर. हा इव्हॅपोरेटर कोणत्या याचा असेल? दॅट इज ऑफ प्रायमरी सर्किट. ओके ओव्हर हियर दिस विल बी अ कंडेन्सर ऑफ सेकंडरी सर्किट. मीन्स ओव्हर हियर वॉटर ऑर ब्राइन सोल्यूशन विल ऍब्सॉर्ब हीट. ओके फ्रॉम द टँक, म्हणजे टँक मध्ये काय असेल आईस समजा आपल्याला हे करायचं आहे, किंवा इथनॉल जे वॉटर आहे ते वॉटर कशासाठी युज केलेलं असेल, पुन्हा चिलिंग साठी युज केलेलं असेल. ओके तर चिलिंग दॅट इज मिल्क चिलिंग साठी आपण पाहिलेलं आहे. आणि हे जे वॉटर किंवा ब्राईन सोल्युशन आहे हे कंटिन्युअसली काय केलेलं असतं, रिसर्क्युलेट केलेलं असतं. आणि वेन वी आर युझिंग दिस सेकंडरी रेफ्रिजरंट, okay, for the applications, if the secondary refrigerant leaks, the that will not too much harmful. Now if the primary refrigerant leaks, definitely it will be harmful. Okay, that's why secondary refrigerants are used where the heat absorption that will not desirable, or heat extraction by the primary refrigerant that will be not desirable. In such applications, secondary refrigerants are used. Now, what is the difference between primary refrigerant and secondary refrigerant? Primary refrigerant and secondary refrigerant. Okay, difference. Now, its refrigerating effect will be more. Okay. Secondary refrigerants are refrigerating effects of cell focus or cell coming cell. Primary refrigerating the refrigerating effect kasa cell just cell. Second thing, leakage is the problem. Leakage. Now the difference between primary and secondary refrigerant. The refrigerating effect is more in case of primary refrigerant. The refrigerating effect is less in case of secondary refrigerant. Okay. Leakage is the problem. Leakage जर झालं तर problem होऊ शकतो, कारण एक तर हे hazardous आहेत. One more thing, that is explosive आहेत. It will catch the fire. Secondary refrigerant मध्ये हा problem येऊ शकत नाही. हे expensive आहे, त्याची cost जी आहे ती जास्त आहे. That is readily available, cost will be less in case of secondary refrigerant. As the refrigerating effect is more, the less quantity of the refrigerant is required over here in case of primary refrigerant. And refrigerating effect is less, more quantity of refrigerant is required. In case of primary refrigerant, there is no need of antifreeze solution. आता antifreeze solution म्हणजे काय असतं बघा, आपण chilling center ला भेट दिलेली आहे. chilling center मध्ये water, तर chilling center ला भेट दिल्यानंतर बघा, त्या ठिकाणी water जो आहे तो secondary refrigerant म्हणून काय केला जायचा, use केला जायचा. Now the freezing point of the water is 0 degree Celsius. If the temperature of the system that is dropped down below 0 degree Celsius, water will get freeze and that will ceases to flow, stop to flow. Okay, and that may cause difficulty. That's why if we add antifreeze solution into the water, its freezing point will get reduced, means that is reduced to -4, -5, -6 degree Celsius. Okay, that is antifreeze solution. Now if we add salt solution in the water, okay, water and salt solution, its freezing point will get reduced up to -20 degree Celsius, and that is the brine solution. Okay, that's why in case of secondary refrigerant there is need of antifreeze solution, so that secondary refrigerant will not get freeze and it will continuously flow into the system. That's why antifreeze solution is required in secondary refrigerant. There is no need of antifreeze solution in primary refrigerant. The primary refrigerant may or may not be corrosive, okay, but secondary refrigerants are mostly corrosive, which will affect the system. That is mostly corrosive, may or may not be corrosive primary. Okay, now desirable properties we will discuss in next lecture. Thank you.